He is a graduate from our master's program in applied economics and finance. He has the honor of obtaining a 4.0 GPA. All the stats courses, quantitative courses, finance courses, micro, macro, and other courses in detail. He also participated during all of this time with the graduate student leadership program on campus. And he plans on pursuing a career in data analytics and consulting either in Toronto or New York City. So welcome.
Record it.
When I first arrived in San Cruz, not having been from California, I didn't know what to expect. I got dropped off at the bus station and made my way downtown. Needless to say, I met some pretty interesting characters on Pacific Avenue. I thought to myself, wow, this is California. They weren't kidding when they said it was liberal. I came to realize that San Cruz is what economists call a non-representative sample. But over the next couple of days, I got to check out the local spots and was truly blown away by the beauty of San Cruz. I was psyched to be going to grad school in such a cool city. The redwoods, and the beach, only an hour away from San Francisco, I still didn't see that hard. Well, fast forward a month into the program, and a buddy from undergrad sent me a Facebook message. Rick, San Cruz seems awesome. How are you liking California? I responded, well, I honestly couldn't tell you anything about California. Haven't had time for the wood, haven't had time for the redwoods, no time for the beach, no time to visit San Francisco. But if you wanted to know anything about the inside of an Engineering 2 building or the library on campus, I'm proud. When I say that the first quarter was by far the hardest we've ever worked. All day classes, countless late nights, demanding coursework, it pushed us all to our limits. That first quarter, we studied macro, micro, and econometrics, basically the three pillars of modern economics. But forcing us to take classes all at the same time forced us to think and view problems like economists. We developed whole new approaches to solve problems, focusing on mathematical reasoning and econometric analysis. This past year has been one of the most rewarding years of my life. This program has taught us the skills necessary to become successful in the modern workforce. However, that success would not have been possible without the quality instructors here at UCSC. The economics professors are not only recognized as tops in their fields, but truly care about the students. Dr. Walsh, who is a distinguished professor here at UCSC, would even take time to hold extra office hours and stay late for exam review sessions. And it was not only Dr. Walsh, but all the professors here. Dr. Bowman, Dr. Freeman, Dr. Walsh, Dr. Spira, Dr. Singh, Dr. Saha, and Dr. Aldridge. Thank you so much. We are proud to have studied underneath you all. I have to once again thank Dr. Spira. Alan was not only our advanced econometrics professor, but he was the master's program director this year. He organized two job fairs and had always made sure we had the best resources available to us. His diligence and concern for students helped make the program a success. Also, a very big thank you to Sandra Reedy. She made every We would not have survived here without her. Graduates, look back on this past year. Think of all the things we've learned. From valuing options in finance, data resampling methods and econometrics, R and data, we've built a foundation that will enhance our skills and make us competitive in any industry. And as we move on with our lives, there will be tough times ahead. That I'm sure. But if you ever doubt yourself, just look back and remember. Remember all those late nights. Remember the struggle for understanding and the satisfaction of comprehension. Be proud of our accomplishment today, because there's proof that we will be able to handle and overcome any adversity in the future, big or small. But not only has this program given us the knowledge and training to become successful, it has introduced us to lifelong friends and future colleagues. I want all of you to look around the room. Notice the diversity and international presence of our master's program. We have students from China, India, Palestine, Iran, Ethiopia, and America, all working together, sharing ideas, and lending strength to each other's weaknesses. When working in such a diverse group, people with different backgrounds brought different strengths to the table, and they were always willing to teach and help their classmates. I've learned just as much from my classmates as I have from my professors. Our cohort represents some of the best and brightest students from around the world. We have grown together and become close friends. A theme of our program was, if you're going to study, then I'm going to study. We pushed each other to be better, but there was always a shoulder to lean on and an open ear to listen. In today's world, innovation lies at the intersection of two fields. Technology has changed the way we all operate the world. From communication to business, technology has pushed us into uncharted territory, breaking down the traditional paradigms that have guided society and business for decades. In these uncharted territories, economic thinking is essential to navigate the challenge today. We are the leaders of tomorrow. We are poised to make an impact on the world with the training we've received. Today we stand smarter, older, and wiser. Today we stand with confidence. 95% confidence. Confidence in our abilities. Confidence in that we will be the ones to drive change, to bring innovation to the forefront. Today is the moment we've been waiting for. Today is our chance to show the world what we can do. Class of 2016, I am so proud of what we've accomplished, and I cannot wait to see what life has in store for us next. Thank you.